and cried with a loud voice as when a lion roareth. And when he had cried, seven thunders uttered their voices. And when the seven thunders had uttered their voices, I was about to write, and I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, seal up those things which the seven thunders uttered, and write them not. According as his divine power hath given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness, through the knowledge of him that hath called us to glory and virtue, whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. And beside this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge, and to knowledge, temperance, and to temperance, patience, and to patience, godliness, and to godliness, brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness, charity. For if these things be in you and abound, they make you that ye shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Messengers, man of the earth. But this angel, these said to the angel of the church of Laodicea, to the angel of the church of Ephesus, messengers of the earth. See, man. Messengers, prophets, and so forth to the church. But this one didn't come from the earth. He come down from heaven. Amen. Because the mystery's all finished. And when the mystery's finished, the angel said, time shall be no more, and seven thunders stole their voices out. What if it is something to let us know how to enter into the rapture in faith? Is it? Will we run, leap over walls? Is there something fixing to happen? These old, marred, vile bodies are going to be changed. Can I live to see it, O Lord? Is it so close that I'll see it? Is this the generation? Sirs, my brethren, what time is it? Where are we at? Let's look at the watch. The calendar, see what date we're living in. Israel is in Palestine, in her homeland. The end sign, the six-point star of David, 2,000 years ago. Yeah, nearly 2,500 years ago, the oldest flag is flying. Israel's back in her homeland. When the fig tree put forth its buds, this generation shall not die, shall not pass out, pass away until all things are fulfilled. Nations are breaking. Israel's awakening. The signs that the prophets foretold. The Gentile days numbered, with harrows encumbered. Return, O dispersed, to your own. The day of redemption is near. Man's hearts are failing for fear. Be filled with the Spirit, your lamps trimmed and clear. Look up, your redemption is near.
Amen.
False prophets are lying. God's truth they're denying. Amen. That Jesus the Christ is our God. You know it's the truth.
Amen.
But we'll walk where the apostles have trod. For the day of redemption is near. Man's hearts are failing for fear. Be filled with the Spirit, your lamps trimmed and clear. Look up, your redemption is near.
Help us, Lord.
Might be closer than you think it is. Got me scared. Oh, I haven't done enough. Where are we at? Time shall be no more. He announces that time is over. What happens? What happens? Could that be so now, brethren? Seriously think, if it is, then the pyramid is capped by the seven thunders. You remember the pyramid message? It's the capstone. What did it do? The Holy Spirit capped off the individual and seal it when we added to our faith righteousness and godliness and faith and so forth. We kept adding to it till we got seven things. And the seventh one was love, which is God. That's how he makes the individual and caps him and seals him with the Holy Spirit. Then, if that be so, he's got seven church ages. That he's had seven mysteries that's been sounded away and they fought for to bring back. And now the headstone comes, the cap off the church. Does the thunders mean that, my brethren? Sirs, is that where we're at?
I tell you something about New York City. Now you watch. Remember, there's something about New York City. Don't forget that. Yeah?
Friday, September 20th, 1974. The following inspiration was given to me between 10:30 a.m. and 11 a.m. The seven thunders are the seven voices of the seven church ages. I ran in the room, dried myself off. And then he said, write it again. And I wrote it again, and he continued. Which are seven manifestations of the Holy Spirit into the church as faith, a live voice, virtue, a live voice, knowledge, a live voice, temperance, a live voice, patience, a live voice, godliness, a live voice, brotherly kindness, a live voice. Seven voices to build the perfect church, to be capped off with the capstone. He builds his individuals the same way. These voices shook the kingdoms of the devil in each age. Paul shook them. Irenaeus shook them. Martin shook them. Luther shook it. Praise Wesley shook it. Malachi 4 shook it. Praise God. It's the live voice that is the thunder that shakes the devil's kingdom. The bride, each age, the bride, live the word, voice, virtue for her age. Malachi 4 restored back to the church seven voices for the bride to live and manifest bodily kindness as her virtue for her age. Therefore, when charity falls, a bride will manifest not one virtue, but she will actually manifest seven voices as thunder to shake the devil's kingdom.
He waited. He made you a spine, something within you to press on. 66, 67 of purpose, hundreds, hundreds, hundreds. Come over here, shut up, hundreds. Come over there, shut up. Chicken, white horse, shut up, hundreds. The hundreds of prayer behind them, they're gathering together. Hallelujah, they give a faith, they show how to prepare. Shut up, hundreds.
The inspiration revelation was to finish the work. Then go down to Puerto Rico, go into Brother Sister Raina and Brother Davis' prayer room. Amen. Play the seventh seal. Hallelujah. You must go to Puerto Rico between March 17th and March 24th. You must go there. Preach for Candelaria on the weekend. And Monday, go over to Brother David and Raina's house. And Monday morning, though you're tired, play the first seal on March 18th. I sat there, I was going to sleep, I was so tired, but he told me to play the first seal in New York before I went. And I called for the same thing again this year, because it's the same day again. Same days. What is it? Oh, it's the 28th anniversary since 1963 of the Seven Seals Barley Harvest.
Oh, hallelujah, praise God. I hope that ignites you or something. Hey, man, I'm trying to tell you little things to help you. I had to do it. I had to speak in a Tucson tabernacle. Who can but prophesy? Praise God. You may be seated. Then wait. Go down to Puerto Rico. I'm laying there. I'm sitting there. I didn't know what the seven thunders was. The Holy Spirit said, then he comes. He said, now the seven thunders there, page 128. He said, when they come or fall out, he says, they will gather the people together. So, and I played that, and the Holy Spirit said, stop the tape. I jumped up. He said, play that back. I heard it again. Seven thunders, they'll gather the people together. He said, stop the tape. Play it back. Played it back again. All of a sudden, boom, inside exploded. Seven thunders gather people together. Seven thunders give faith. Seven thunders brings revival inside. Water inside here. Revelation. That's all I knew.
Amen. Now, in his promised word, you won't have to interpret it. He will interpret it through you. What you are doing, what he promised to do, the church that follows him, here it is, will be so much like him until the people will know. Amen. You won't have to say nothing. Amen. There goes a Christian. Amen. Wow. Amen. Dripping a Christian with charity. Amen. Amen. See? Peter and John, they were questioned after healing a man at the gate called Beautiful. They said that they perceived the priest that they were both ignorant, unlearned man, but they take notice that they had been with Jesus, getting them seven steps. Because what? They were doing the things he did. And we're only divine with our seven steps. Without him, we can do nothing without charity.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Peter had so much virtue, they were healing his shadow. How are you going to get temperance without virtue? If you got virtue, stand up and let somebody be healed in your shadow. Oh, now let's come and get some faith in this morning. Amen. Before we go way over there up the ladder somewhere. Amen. Let's get the faith first. Amen. Because you say you got temperance or patience. Where's the virtue? Virtue is dynamics, healing power. The woman touched Jesus' clothes and virtue, he turned. Virtue went out of him. Healing power, dynamics went out. What a revelation. And he had a sign to prove it was him in there too. He told the seekers of the heart and prophesied things that happened and healed the sick and spoke and created, even created a jawbone and set the lost's jaw. So we in New York City would know that he was creating and not to look for something way down the road. He was already doing it in New York. Amen. What a sign came to Brother Hunt and I. So therefore in 65, they could go west, east, south, north. I didn't care. I knew he was here. Amen. What a sign. He waved up and waved goodbye in New York, but I've already created a blood cell and set the Lawson's jawbone. So don't look for all these funny things. They're flying everywhere. Amen. I even give you a picture that Malachi 4 is going up in with three horses. He's leaving. There's a mantle to fall behind. Catch the mantle. Amen. The mantle is faith, virtue, knowledge, temperance. Amen. Amen. Patience, godliness, brotherly kind. That's the mantle. Amen. Then wrap it around you. Come on down to the Jordan. Stand there. Amen. Where is the Lord God of Elijah?
But now, after we got our first three steps, which come from God, God gave the faith. He heals. Amen. And he gives spiritual knowledge. Now, what are we going to do with it? We know he's here. And he gives us these things to a special group. And we got it. Vindicated by the miraculous. Now, but what are we going to do with it? Well, here we are this morning. We're going to find out. Now, these next four things is what we do with what we got. If, in other words, now temperance, patience, godliness, and brotherly kindness is what we can do now. There you are. That's what we can do in appreciation back. Oh, my God, you did this for me. Lord, I'm coming out of the world. That's it. I'm going to live for you. I'm going to breathe for you. I'm going to walk for you, talk for you. Amen. I want to sleep and die for you. Amen.
seven thunders utter their voices to that group who really can take the word of God and hand it there, it'll slice and cut. They can close the heavens, they can shut this or do that, whatever they want to. You'll be swayed by the word that proceeds through his mouth is sharper than a two-edged sword. They could call for 100 billion tons of flies if they wanted to. Whatever they say is going to happen because it's the word of God coming from the mouth of God.
And I say by the faith in the word of God, there's some new skin sitting here this morning. Amen. There's some being delivered every day by the word, by this seventh thunder revelation. You are redeemed now. Praise God. Amen. We're sitting in heavenly places. Oh my, those new skins with new wine. New life began to expand. There wasn't enough room in the upper room to hold them. Tight. They needed some room. Out they come down the steps, out into the street of Jerusalem. They expanded, they give, they stretched out. Oh, praise God, until all Jerusalem began to wonder, what meaneth this? And then Peter stood up there with a seventh thunder revelation. This is that the prophet Joel speak of. I pour out my new wine into some new skins. And this morning I'm persuaded that I can stand here and say, this is that the prophet Malachi spake of. The new wine is coming into you now. If you want the Holy Ghost, you can have it now. Just say, Lord God, give me the Holy Ghost. If you want a healing, you can have the healing right now. The new wine is here now. He's pouring the new wine upon you. We're here. The dynamics and the mechanics is going forth together. Oh, praise God. Praise our God. Praise our God. Praise God. Amen. Thank you, Lord.